You guys give me five. All right, nice job. Thank you for quieting down so quickly. Welcome, everybody. It's great to see so many of you here today for our First Friday Assembly and our Veterans Day program. Each month we do an assembly, we recognize some students, and we talk about our new character treat. So we're gonna start the afternoon with that. And then we have a special program that Mrs. Steedman and our fifth graders put together that we're gonna wrap up with at the end to honor our veterans. So we'll get started right away. We wanna recognize some of our students. Each month, in each of our classrooms, our teachers select three students to recognize to receive an Outstanding OWL Award. And this Outstanding OWL Award can be earned for many different things. It can be our character trait for the month. It can be showing kindness, being a good friend. It could be showing growth in an area where they were struggling. So all kinds of things, and these students are gonna get an award today, and they'll have a personalized little note on there on what they received it for. So at this time, I'm gonna ask my first grade team if they can come up and help me hand out the awards. We got Mrs. Corral, Mrs. Dorzak, and Mrs. Schlamer. All right, so students, listen for your name, and when I call your name, come on up. We're gonna start with 4K through second grade. Actually, 4K through first grade. And some of these 4K kids might not be here because they were in the morning program. So we got Gianna Busilaki, Brooks Schmidt, Macy Skick. So if those kiddos are here, come on up. All right. Also in 4K, we got Cassia Spunk, Lucy Hug, and Brinley Seaford. Come on up, Cassius. There you go. And Grayson Nauman, Bella Bayer, and Ricky Hankey. All right, in 5K, we got Maddie Alexander, Gavin Herther, Olivia Strom, Weston Mueller, Natalie Smet, Rosie Steffen, Kendrick Kearns, Roman Mergner, and April Ransom. We'll let these guys catch up with awards. Camden Milius, Paisley Tesloff, Sienna Del Rio, Rosie Miller, Delilah Yang, Maya Loper, Aria Meyer, and Scarlett Sands. Give these students another round of applause for being outstanding OWLs for the last month. Great job, students. You may hit the bow. All right, and go find your seats. Nice job, guys. All right, next up we have our second and third graders. So come on up when I call your name. Ellen Blummel, Connor Leiser, Noah Verhassel, Sage Kuga, Remy Wiseman, Sydney Willis, Liam Adkins, Alex Beers, Grayson Sarnow. In third grade, Arianis Lopez, Lucy Leck, Blake Novotny, Bo Miller, Aubrey Hartman, Rylan Aller, Kaden Kolpak, Mackenzie Grippentrug, and Lola Morkey. Great job, students, being outstanding owls. Let's give them another round of applause for all of our second and third graders. All right, you guys want to take a bow? All right, nice job. And last but not least, our fourth and fifth graders. Come on up when I call your name. Kiera Hintz, Josh Bachhuber, Giovanna Carrion, Lily Schultz, Emmett Craney, Timothy Keycaper, Eli Meyer, Carson Martin, and Kendall Parrell. And our fifth graders, Grayson Broker, Ashlyn Rutson, Ireland Walker, Jordy Scott, Adeline Spicer, Nola Mayhew, Bentley Holes, Mason Bremseth, and Camille Chiash. Great job to all these fourth and fifth graders for doing a great job last month being recognized as outstanding owls. Let's give them another round of applause. Great job, guys. You want to take a bow? All right, excellent. Thank you, first grade teachers. All right, guys, give me five so we can keep going. All right, thank you. So just a quick note, outstanding owls, all of you got a certificate today. Just a reminder, we'll have principal's breakfast, so they get to come have breakfast with me next week, Wednesday, right after the announcements. I'll call you down to the cafeteria. So each month we do a character trait, and last month our character trait was self-discipline. So some of the students who might have just been up here might have been recognized for that. But we're gonna have our film crew come up. Normally they make a film, but today they're gonna talk in person about our next character trait for the month of November. So film crew, please come on up here.
To remind you about the buddy bench, since friendship is all about having fun and playing with each other. Remember, the buddy bench is a bench to sit on outside if you don't have anyone to play with.
This is how it works. When you see someone sitting on the bench, go up to them and ask them if they would like to join you.
This month, teachers will be looking for students who are
honest, keep promises, and treat others with kindness.
If they are disrespectful, apologize, say I'm sorry, and mean what they say.
When you see somebody on the buddy bench, go over and ask him or her to play.
Don't make fun of others because it's what's on the inside that counts.
Try to be friends with people who are different from you.
Remember, friends don't tell just to get someone in trouble. Be a foot and debug when needed.
At Addison, we stand up for what is right and be a friend.
All right, and next week we're going to be celebrating kindness, which goes along with friendship, and Mrs. Foss is going to talk a little bit about what we're doing for Kindness Week next week.
All right, so next week is Kindness Week, so we are going to celebrate by having some morning announcements next week to think about how we can spread kindness and make Addison an even better place to be. And on Wednesday, if you have a kindness shirt, you can feel free to wear, if you have like a shirt that says a kind message, you can wear that on Wednesday. And then in your classroom, you guys are going to be putting down on colored paper when somebody is kind to you and how they were kind. And we're gonna collect all those strips of paper and we're gonna connect them all together and display them in our hallway to show how we can spread kindness at Addison.
All right, thank you, Mrs. Foss. And next up, we're gonna go ahead and get started with our Veterans Day program. I know we have a lot of veterans in here today, so we're excited to honor you and celebrate you. Thank you for coming. And with that, I'm gonna get it turned over to Mrs. Steedman.
Hello there, I am Mrs. Steedman, and I am the music teacher here at Addison. And we're very excited to present our Veterans Day observance for you. We do have a bit of a transition here because I have to get kids on the stage. So all of our Addison students, remember your best behavior while we're presenting this program. Don't talk with your neighbors and be good listeners. Fifth graders, I know you're not in height order, that's my fault, but you know where to stand. So calmly walk down the middle aisle. My scouts may go to the back and get into your two lines.
Students, staff, and family, and a very warm welcome to all the veterans and active service members here with us today. We are honored to gather here to recognize and remember all the men and women who have served in our nation's military.
Well, Veterans Day is a day to honor those who have served. We are also appreciative of all of the active service members who are in attendance today.
We now ask you to stand and remove all hats as members of Cub Scout Pack 3731. Posting of our nation's flag.
Color guard, attention. Those not in uniform, please place your right hand over your heart. Color guard, forward march. Color guard, halt. Color guard, cross the colors. Please recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance guard, post the flag of the United States. Color guard, post the flag of PAC 3731. Color guard, face the flag and honor your colors. So salute. Color guard, dismissed. Audience, be seated. Oh, you're not gonna like me. I'm really sorry. We're gonna have to stand up in a second.
Please continue as and fifth grade students lead us in the singing of the national anthem.
Today is our privilege to say thank you to all of America's veterans, to let them know that we appreciate them for their service and honor them for their sacrifices.
The following words are inscribed in the Korean War Memorial in Washington, D.C. Our nation honors her sons and daughters who answered the call to defend a country they never knew and a people they never met.
Those words apply equally to our World War I, World War II, Vietnam War, and Gulf War veterans, as well as today's active duty service members help maintain peace throughout the world. Our next song is called We Are New. During this song, fifth grade students will be bringing out a small gift for veterans as well as active service members. Please raise your hand when they come by so they can give you a token of appreciation. On the gift, there is a small poem. I am part of our American flag that has flown over our home in the USA. I can no longer fly. The sun and winds have caused me to become tattered and torn. Please carry me as a reminder that you are not forgotten. And now the song, We Honor You.
We are.
It's common for people to not quite understand who a veteran is or what Veterans Day is for. A simple way of looking at it is a veteran is a person who served in the military in peacetime or during a war. Veterans work to protect us and our freedom.
There are now 6 branches in the U.S. military. I'm going to read each of them. New branches called, please stand if you are able so that we can thank you with a round of applause. Space Force. Navy. Coast Guard. Marines. Air Force. And Army.
The Space Force anthem in the coming years.
Veterans and active service members, when our anthem is played, please feel free to stand and sing along as while the fifth grade students sing the military medley.
Over hill.
I'll conclude our program as we do each and every year with the song Proud to be an American. Our fifth grade students have brought in pictures of relatives and friends who have served or are currently serving in the military.
To all the veterans in attendance today, thank you again for the sacrifices you have made to provide a safe and peaceful country for us to live in. We truly appreciate you, not only on Veterans Day, but on each and every day. Thank you.
We have a brief pause because we'll be using the screen. So our fifth graders are going to sing from the side, and we'll get this all set up for you.
Thank you.
Before we have our Cub Scouts take the flags down, so Cub Scouts, you can quietly go line up in the back. I would like to have everybody give the fifth graders one more round of applause for their great job. Not only did they sing very well, but they took this program very seriously this year and put a lot of effort making the posters in the hallway, even when they were setting up the chairs and everything, they wanted everything to be perfect. So I really appreciate your efforts and your acknowledgement of the importance of this holiday. After the Cub Scouts take the flags, we're going to ask that any veteran or active service member that's in attendance today to please wait. We'd like to take a photograph of all of you together. So again, after the flags are taken down, we'll have the students go with their teachers, and again, audience members, if you could let them clear out first, that would be great. All right. Color guard, advance. Color guard, watch where you're going. Color guard, retrieve the colors. Audience, please rise and place your hand over your heart. Color guard, dismissed. Audience, you may be seated. Let's give one more round of applause for our veterans in attendance today. Thank you all. And I do this every year, so I need to embarrass my relatives really quickly. So could I have Lee Krieger, my dad, and Kurt Schultz, my uncle, stand up and wave, because I'm the music teacher and I can do that. They were both in the Army. Give them a round of applause. All right. Thank you all for coming. Students, you were an excellent audience. I'm so proud of you. Have a great weekend. And students, please look to your teachers so you know when to go. Thank you. Bye.